And look at Ata ibn Abi Rabah, one of the greatest of the scholars of the history of Islam. And he was born a slave, and he was black. And he had a severe limp, كان شديد العرج, a severe limp. And he was blind in one of his eyes, and later on would be blind from both of his eyes. All of the things that the ignorant people care about, he had all of them in him. And none of it stopped him. He was freed by his master, because she found no use in him. He went to his mother crying that she freed him, because at least when he was a slave, he had a roof to live under and food would be given to him. Now he was freed and there was nothing for him to do. He went to his mother crying. And what did his mother say to him? She said to him, Ya Bunay, أتريد عز الدنيا والآخرة? She said, Oh my son, do you want the glory of this world and the next world? And he said to her, Yes. She said, قالت اطلب العلم فوالله ليرفعنك الله فوق الرؤوس. She said to him, Go and seek knowledge, for indeed Allah will lift you over the leaders with knowledge. She didn't belittle his ability. She didn't tell him you're not capable. She didn't tell him you can't do anything. No, rather she pushed him and she encouraged him and she told him to go seek knowledge and to go work for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he went and he was poor and he was homeless and he began to live in the masjid, in Masjid al-Haram, for more than 20 years. كان المسجد فراش Ata ibn Abi Rabah 20 سنة. 20 years he was homeless, living inside of the masjid. And there he was studying and he was learning. And the people asked, how did he live? The students, after he passed away, they said, how did he live for 20 years? قالوا صلة الإخوان ونيل السلطان. He would receive some money from the authorities that they would give every Muslim, and he would receive the provisions and the help of his relationships with his brothers. His brothers would give him some food, help him with a little bit of money. This is how he lived until he became the most knowledgeable of the people of Mecca. So knowledgeable that when Abdullah ibn Umar came into Mecca, he is the companion of the Prophet. And the people went to him and started asking him questions. He said to them, Ya Ahl Mecca, تجمعون لي المسائل وعندكم عطاء بن أبي رباح. He said, Oh people of Mecca, are you gathering questions for me? And you have amongst you عطاء بن أبي رباح. And he became one of the greatest of the students of Abdullah ibn Abbas. And he became so knowledgeable, they said, no one can give a fatwa in Mecca other than Ata ibn Abi Rabah. Until there was a day that the Khalifa Sulaiman ibn Abd al-Malik came to perform his Hajj in Mecca. And he wanted to ask some questions about Hajj. They said to him, you have to go to Ata. No one can give the fatwa other than Ata. So he went and he found a long lineup of people in front of Ata. And he came to Ata and he wanted to get in front of the line and ask his questions. So Ata asked him, are these questions for you or are they for all of the Muslims? Meaning, are you asking as the leader, as the Khalifa, about matters that affect everyone or matters that only affect you? So he said, "Hum khasatan bi," they are specific to me. So he told him, wait in line. So the Khalifa waited in line while he answered the questions of every other person in line. And finally, when Sulaiman ibn Abd al-Malik's turn was up, he asked his questions, and Ata answered his questions, and finally he left. And with him were two of his sons. And Sulaiman turned to two of his sons, and he said to him, وَاللَّهِ مَا رَأَيْتُ نَفْسِي فِي مَوْتٍ أَذَلُّ مِنِّي كَمَا كُنْتُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهَا بِالْعَبْدِ. He said, وَاللَّهِ I never saw myself more humiliated than in the standing between the slave. And then he said to his sons, يَا بُنَيْ اطْلُبُ الْعِلْمِ. O my sons, seek knowledge. Go and seek knowledge. فَبِالْعِلْمِ يُشْرَفْ الْوَضِيعُ وَيَعْمُ الْأَرْفَاءَ عَلَى مَرَاتِبِ الْمُلُوكِ. He said, with knowledge, those who are humble and lowly are raised and given honor and nobility. And those who are servants and slaves become raised above the kings, just as he saw in his life. This is our religion. It gives empowerment to those who might have difficulties in their life and disabilities. They are our brothers and our sisters, and we are obliged to help them and to support them in every capacity that we can.